In this video, I am going to show you a quick and easy way to create custom Sudoku puzzles for free using ChatGPT. No extra tools required. Whether you enjoy Sudoku as a hobby or want to sell printables on Etsy or publish Sudoku puzzle books on Amazon KDP, this method will help you get started fast. However, there are some important warnings to be aware of while using this approach, and I will share those at the end of the video. So make sure to watch until the very end. Sudoku is a classic logic-based number puzzle. The goal is to fill a 9x9 grid with numbers so that each row, column, and 3x3 subgrid contains all digits from 1 to 9 without repeating. Let's walk through the steps to generate your own Sudoku puzzle. Start by asking ChatGPT to create a 9x9 Sudoku grid. My prompt is, please generate an easy 9x9 Sudoku puzzle with a solution. As you can see, ChatGPT quickly generates a puzzle for you. If you copy this and paste it into an Excel sheet, it will appear like this. You can copy each number and paste it into the cells individually, but that can be time consuming. That's why I will ask ChatGPT if it can provide a format that is easier to copy directly into Excel. My prompt is, can you provide the exact Sudoku puzzle and its solution in a format that I can copy directly into Excel? Okay, let's copy the Sudoku puzzle to see if each number can be pasted into different cells. Looks like it works. Now let's copy its solution as well. It's a good idea to center align the numbers. The 0 represents empty cells in the Sudoku puzzle, so we need to remove them. Rather than deleting them one by one, we can use the Find and Replace feature in Excel. Highlight the range of cells with the Sudoku puzzle. Press Ctrl plus H to open the Find and Replace dialog box. In the Find What field, type 0 and leave the Replace With field blank. Click Replace All. All instances of 0 will be replaced with blank cells. Click OK on the confirmation message, then click Close to exit the Find and Replace dialog. If you plan to use this Sudoku for commercial purposes, it's better to format it properly. First, highlight the columns containing your Sudoku puzzle and its solution. Right-click and choose Column Width. Set the width to a value like 3 or 4 to make the cells more square-shaped. I will go with 3. Next, highlight the rows containing your Sudoku puzzle and its solution. Right-click again and choose Row Height. Set the height to a value like 20 or 25 to match the columns and create a square grid. Let's set it to 20. The reason for entering different values for column width and row height in Excel is that they are measured differently. Column width is measured in character units, meaning the width is based on how many characters, like letters or numbers, can fit in a cell. A width of 3 or 4 means the column will be wide enough to fit about 3-4 characters. Row height is measured in points, which are similar to font sizes. A height of 20 to 25 points gives you a reasonably sized cell to match the width visually. If you are a perfectionist, I will measure the width and height of the cells in Adobe Illustrator and show you soon. To enhance the look of the Sudoku grid, we should add borders to mark the 9x9 grid and the 3x3 subgrids. With the range still selected, right-click and choose Format Cells. First, set the outline and inside borders. Then, use the same method to highlight the 3x3 subgrids with thicker borders. Once you have created one subgrid, use the Format Painter to replicate it across the rest. Alright, our Sudoku puzzle is all set. I know many of you use Canva for publishing on Amazon KDP, but there is one catch. You can't directly paste an Excel table into Canva. Don't worry, I will show you how to import it easily in just a moment. First, let's copy this Excel table into Adobe Illustrator to check if the grid sizes are close to square. Let me zoom in a bit. As you can see, the height and width of the squares are pretty close, so I don't think this slight gap will be an issue visually when you print this page. To import this into Canva, we first need to take a screenshot of the Sudoku grid from Excel. If we simply screenshot it as it is, those light colored borders around the edges will show up. So let's create a clean white background in Excel before capturing the screenshot. Select any neighboring cells around your Sudoku grid that you don't want to show. Right-click on the selected area, go to Format Cells, then click on the Fill tab. Choose white as the fill color and click OK. This will give your grid a crisp white background. Now you will have a clean grid ready to capture, showing just the Sudoku without any surrounding cells. Now, save this image and apply the same method to its solution. The next step is uploading these images to Canva. Open Canva and create or open your design. In the left-hand panel, go to the Upload section and click Upload Files. Select the screenshot you just took and upload it to Canva. Once uploaded, click the image to add it to your design. Resize and position it as needed. Okay, I think it's clear now how to create custom Sudoku puzzles for free using ChatGPT. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, there are some important warnings to keep in mind when using this approach. The first and most crucial warning is that I have noticed ChatGPT can occasionally make mistakes with the solutions. Let me show you an example from my earlier tests. If you take a look at the Sudoku and its solution, you will see that the last row contains 2 ones, 2 twos, and is missing both 6 and 9. So, it's a good idea to ask ChatGPT to confirm whether the solution is valid after it generates the answers for double checking. Now, I will copy this response and ask if it is correct. Can you validate the solution? As it is checking each row, column, and subgrid, it's confirming that the solution is invalid. Let's see if it can create 10 more Sudoku puzzles along with their solutions in the same format to check if it will make any mistakes. Can you create 10 more Sudoku puzzles along with their solutions in the same format? Okay, it looks like ChatGPT is generating them in the original format, but you can ask it to change that just like I did before. I suggest that you ask ChatGPT to validate each solution and also verify them yourself. Let's ask it now. Can you validate each solution individually? If any solution is found to be invalid, you can request that ChatGPT provide an alternative. Verifying your puzzles manually can enhance your skills and lead to a better product. I recommend doing this before publishing your book on Amazon KDP. It may seem time-consuming, but it helps you understand the quality of your work and can prevent negative reviews. Remember, if you don't enjoy creating in a niche, consider switching it to one that interests you more. You are more likely to succeed in areas you are passionate about. I think you got my point. My second warning relates to the difficulty levels of Sudoku puzzles. They are generally categorized into 3 levels: easy, medium, and hard. This classification is based on various factors, including the number of clues provided in the grid, the techniques required to solve the puzzles, and their overall complexity. For example, easy Sudoku puzzles typically have a higher number of clues, usually 35 or more. Medium puzzles have a moderate number of clues, generally ranging from 25 to 34. Hard puzzles, on the other hand, usually feature fewer clues, around 17 to 24. As a reminder, my initial prompt was, please generate an easy 9x9 Sudoku puzzle with a solution. However, the puzzle generated contained only 30 clues. While the number of clues isn't the sole factor in determining difficulty, it might be helpful to specify this in your prompt, such as, please generate an easy 9x9 Sudoku puzzle with 35 clues. My final warning relates to large print Sudoku puzzles, which are particularly preferred by seniors and older adults with vision impairments. According to KDP guidelines, you need a minimum font size of 16 points to qualify as large print. It's easier to manage this if you use design tools like Adobe Illustrator. However, if you take a screenshot and upload it to Canva as an image, as we just did, you will need to measure the size manually. To do this, click on Text in the left menu and add a text box. Choose your font and set it to 16 points. Type a number and compare it to the numbers in the Sudoku puzzle. For instance, I need a larger Sudoku grid to fit large print here. This 6x9 page only allows for a maximum of 2 Sudoku grids with a font size of 16 per page. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please subscribe and like the video to support the channel. Thanks for watching. See you soon.